Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. We are jumping right into picks and bans right now for this first matchup. The first ban is already in, and it's going to be Hell. Not too much of a surprise there. Hell just kind of needs to get banned regardless of what team is playing. Probably going to see a Sun Wukong ban too.
Solbeck.
Solbeck.
That's a respect ban.
Yeah. The Kepri too. Why do you think the Kepri got banned out?
He's just the top guardian right now.
Yeah. Yeah. So there's the Sun Wukong. Yeah. So looking right now, Epsilon is going to come in as your order team and Onslaught is going to be coming in as your chaos team. So the Sobek, though, who's that a respect ban against?
Seelkar.
Oh, okay.
He plays him very well in the solo lane.
Yeah, so we've seen Sobek already in this league do a lot of really... Oh, yeah, Janus is going to get locked in. That's why you have to watch out. That's why you usually see the Janus ban over the Kepri. What do you think? How important is this Janus going to be in this matchup?
Janus is all-around like good character, mid, late, early. Late game, you can't even kill him.
Yeah, he's so strong in a team fight too, and he's so mobile. He can get anywhere at absolutely no notice.
Five,
yeah, he can move across the map. So that's going to be really big for Epsilon. Looking over at Onslaught right now, we are going to see Shivalanka get locked in. That's one of your favorites.
Yeah, that's my favorite guy.
Yeah, so that is exciting to see the Shivalanka. We also have the Athena. I'm surprised, though, with the Athena that they didn't opt in to Medusa. Yeah, just to get that combo.
I mean, yeah, I do. That's what you want to do, but Shivalanka is open, so why not?
Yeah, right. We have seen a lot of Shivalanka get played. I haven't seen anyone play the Wombo combo in our league yet, so I'm a little curious if it's kind of fallen out of favor. Oh, these are two interesting picks. I guess Wheelish is probably going to play in the jungle.
Yeah.
And then we'll have, where do you think Shen will play?
He can either go solo or support.
Or support, yep. Yeah. I mean, we've seen him do some pretty nasty things as support just because he can control where the other players are and how the ADC is actually going to hit them.
Poseidon.
Yeah, Poseidon. Poseidon is just, with the right comp too, so disgusting in a team fight. Once that Kraken gets dropped. I'm a little curious, though, to see who they actually pick next. Oh, so we're going to have the third bans come in.
Ares ban.
Yeah, what do you think about that Ares ban?
I don't know.
Yeah, that doesn't really make sense. That Ares ultimate is, of course, really, really nasty. It's really strong. Okay, Ymir, Poseidon. Now, that's a winning combination right there. Who do you think is going to be taking the Ymir, though? It looks like they're probably a jungle Ymir, right?
It could be Athena also.
Yeah, they could jungle with Athena. That's what's so nice about the Ymir pick, right? Like, you can really... It can go anywhere.
Yeah.
Yeah, Geb support. That's...
Yeah, definitely Geb support.
Pretty standard. Who is Epsilon support? Do you know?
Kenshin.
Is he particularly good with Geb? I don't know his God pool very well.
He's very good with Geb.
Yeah. So that is definitely going to be... it's pretty dangerous. When you have someone who's good with Geb... Oh, so they're actually going to pick up Medusa. Medusa, Geb? Or... Oh, okay. Oh, yeah, kind of lock into Medusa. Going to mess with us a little bit there. Show us the Neath, and then go right back to Medusa and lock in. We have one pick left for Onslaught. Right now, they're banned out of Kepri, Thor, and Hell.
I don't know, because...
Yeah. What are you thinking?
They're missing a solo laner, so probably Guan Yu.
Yeah, Guan Yu would be really strong here. And Guan Yu in a team fight with you.
Oh, Bologna. Oh, yeah.
That's understandable. That's definitely a strong pick. We've seen a lot of shenanigans get pulled off with Bologna. The Shivalanka is definitely looking scary. In a team fight with Ymir and Poseidon.
Yeah. And they have Athena taunt to Kraken.
Oh, yeah. Athena taunt right into the Kraken. Right up against a Ymir wall. They're looking really strong in a team
Poseidon
fight.
Yeah, Poseidon has a lot of setup.
Yeah, they definitely look strong in a team fight. How do you think the Epsilon comp will actually fare against this absolute powerhouse that Onslaught has put together? Do you think they can actually hold their own?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, the Geb shield late game could literally dodge a Kraken.
Yeah. And also, they do have Janus.
Yeah.
So they're going to have Janus fly across the map and get to the team fight, so they won't really... It's not going to be too often that they're going to be 4v5ing or 3v2ing or anything like that. Janus will just pop that ultimate and get right there. And once he's there, he's also incredibly strong in the team fight. So it looks like Janus is going to be in the mid lane faced up against Poseidon.
So it's a mere jungle.
Yeah, Ymir's definitely, it looks like Ymir's going to be in the jungle. And
Athena support.
Athena support.
Alona solo.
Alona solo is going to be really strong, especially is it going to be Seal Card?
Is Bologna versus Jing Ting? I've never seen that before.
Yeah, that's a weird matchup. Who do you favor in that, personally? It's just a weird matchup. I would favor Bologna just because of how effectively she does clear those waves, while not really. It does drain her mana quite a bit, but she is able to get in with that Scourge and get a few pokes off too. So that might be really strong. And yeah, Xingqian, he is very effective at clearing waves, but I tend to like him more as a support, personally. Yeah. Just because that throw, that messes people up. That absolutely messes people up. And yeah, so a wheelish Ymir in jungle, who do you think wins that?
I mean, you can't. The Ymir freeze early game, like, you can't really play aggressive. You have to, like, clear the camp and try to get out as quick as possible because they have Poseidon also. So they can Ymir freeze you into a whirlpool, and that's potentially death.
Yeah, so actually looking at this, like, a wheelish isn't going to be able to counter jungle too much. There's not going to be too much counter jungling going on. So Ymir might get a little aggressive. Not really sure. We're going to just have to see how they decide to play this Ymir. But Awilish is just going to have to make sure she's getting all of her camps down.
Yeah, but Awilish's early game is crazy as well.
Yeah, definitely very strong. Definitely no joke, but I don't know how Awilish is going to perform in a team fight when against something like Ymir. It's just so strong in a team fight. Like you said, there's so much setup there. This whole team just looks like...
it's dangerous.
It's just, yeah, it's crazy. This is probably the strongest comp I have seen. And that is after they didn't ban... we didn't see Onslaught nor Epsilon ban this Janus. So you kind of assume Janus is going to be... like, anyone who gets Janus just is going to have a stronger comp. But looking at this, I don't see that. I think I favor Epsilon's build. Or sorry, Onslaught's build over Epsilon's build.
I'm still confused about the Ares ban.
Yeah, I don't really get that either.
I don't understand.
It seemed like a wasted ban. I actually, when you're looking and trying to figure out, like, who do you not want in the solo lane, and they knew that they were going to pick, they already knew they had Xingqian in the solo lane, so they could try to counter it. And like you said, Alona does match up pretty well to Xingqian. So they could have banned out Bologna, or they could have banned out something that they were more afraid of. I don't see Ares being a big threat to that solo lane. I really don't. And that was all they had left to pick. So that's definitely going to be interesting. We're getting into the game. The players are going to load in right now. We'll actually maybe get to see what they were thinking, though. Their build, by no means, though, it's definitely not a joke. It's definitely really strong. It's just matched up against this... there's crazy burst potential in the team fight. For Onslaught. Early game though, who do you think will win out the early game with
early
these
game
comps?
In the dueling for sure, Medusa and Geb, just because Medusa's clear. Shablanka doesn't really have clear.
Yeah, Medusa will be able to clear more effectively. So the Geb shield, how strong is that early? Who do you think is stronger, the Geb as support, or do you think that the support
Athena late game, if she gets those 2-3 man taunts, that's good enough, like, and that's for 3 seconds also. So
yeah, so that is going to be really, really strong. Let's actually scooch over and use this PC right now instead of the other one. We're gonna actually look at Xingqian right off the bat and see where he's hanging out. We actually might have a little bit of a scuffle going on in the jungle. If we move over to Athena here.
Yeah, they just water his speed.
Your keyboard is set up very differently than mine. So I actually, there we go. Here's the Shivalanka. Let me see if I can find the Athena. Yeah, thanks. That is a little off. Not quite sure why that's going on. Sorry about that. Actually, let's just move over right now to the Geb and see how he gets into lane. We're having a little bit of problems with the audio pickup on my PC, so we're going to actually scooch over and use this one. But yeah, no, nothing too crazy out of the jungle. No early first blood. We're going to see everyone move into their camps right now and pick up the buffs. Looks like first they're going to be going for that damage buff.
Looks like dual lane is going for mid camps.
Yeah, that's a little interesting.
And they're doing three-man star on the right.
Oh, yeah, that's... I guess that's just kind of a respect thing, right? They're just going to go in right now and try to polish up that camp really quick. Yeah, why do you think they went for that? Do you think that was just because they were scared of a counter jungle?
I think they three-man the right side. Actually, I don't know. Oh, they're invading.
Yeah, it looks like they're actually... Yeah, they're going to try to invade right now. Who do you think wins in this teamfight right now? Oh, yeah, they're just going to back off. Medusa might swing back around, though, and try to poke in a little bit of extra damage. Geb is moving around to support her, too. We could see a first blood right here. Shibalanka is getting a decent amount of damage on Medusa.
Oh, Geb got the purple bomb.
Yeah, Geb ended up taking it. I mean, you can't let the other team get it at the end of the day. Might as well have it go to someone on your team. Does look like everyone's going to move to lane, though, now.
Athena Shibalanka is behind XP because of that.
Yeah, they had to stay out of lane for quite some time. So that could end up mattering, and we could see First Blood actually go down in this duo lane right now. Yeah, we are seeing Athena only at level 1. Yeah, I'm... Yeah, we
take
could
a look
actually...
at the mid lane.
In which lane?
Aurelix.
Oh.
Aurelix?
Sorry.
Three. Look like she's going for early gank.
Not quite sure why that went to Medusa. Sorry about that. I'm not sure what is up with this keyboard. Here we go. Actually getting a look at it a little bit right now. That early gank. She took a lot of damage there, but the teamfight's definitely still going on. Poseidon is going to
get first
blood on a Wheelie, actually punishing that attempt to gank.
Yeah.
Looking right now back in the duo lane. They were not involved in that gank at all, so they are already at level 3. So they do have a bit of a favorable matchup right now in this duo lane, even though the first blood has already gone to Onslaught.
Let's take a look at the solo lane. I'm curious how that matchup goes.
Yeah, looking right now, we could actually be seeing a fight right now in the solo lane. Sorry about that, looking at the XP camp right now. Let me see if I can get this other PC to work.
There you go.
Yeah, the numbers just got a little bit messed up there. We should have this problem resolved, though, now. Yeah, but looking right now, both teams definitely do look really strong. Might see a little bit of a boxing match here, though, but it does look like the Xing Chen's a little bit under XP. Right now, that it's an even matchup, though.
Yeah, I think he lacks on clear.
Yeah. And I think a lot of that actually came from earlier when he moved into camps. Yeah, looking at player damage, though, right now, we have seen Bologna put out a lot of player damage, which is pretty, pretty good if you're Onslaught right now, because she's healthy. She's very healthy right now. She's putting on pressure. She's wave clearing incredibly fast, and that's why I'm not sure we didn't see the ban on Bologna. Are you seeing any reason why they would have banned the Ares?
No reason at all.
Yeah, it's a little bit...
Probably another respect ban.
Do you know anyone who is particularly good on Ares on either of these teams?
Yeah, Kenshin.
Kenshin's really good?
Yeah.
Okay, so that might be why. Yeah. So we're actually going to see this Scourge heal up Bologna right now. It's every 3 hits, right? That just
heals you.
Yeah. That really just gives so much sustain. Like right now, we are going to see another one of the XP mid camps go down, and we have a party going on in the mid lane. This might be a little bit of an initiation here. Yeah, they're moving right over to that XP camp, trying to invade. Let's see if this actually ends up going anywhere. Oh, it looks like they might just get the XP camp right now.
Yeah, I think they're giving it up.
Yeah, it looks like Epsilon is actually pulling back. If they come into... Yeah, it doesn't look like they're going to initiate anything there. That could be pretty dangerous for them right now. That's a lot of XP they just gave up. We're actually looking at the graphs right now. Not too much of an XP lead, though. We are seeing Onslaught take a little bit of an XP lead. The goal lead is definitely real, though, at this point.
I think that was just First Blood.
Yeah, I think it was First Blood, too. But looking over right now, it seems like everyone's just kind of playing.
Yeah, just farming it up.
Yeah. And there's not really much else that they should be doing right now. Getting too aggressive right now, if something goes wrong, it could put them terribly behind. Let's actually look at the builds, though. What do you think of these builds?
Blanking with Bluestone, Transcendence. Deuce is going Dev Gloves.
Nothing too out of the ordinary, though, nope. Right?
Yeah, just standard, though.
Yeah. Yeah. Who do you think, though, is going to be the one to really pull out the stops here and try to initiate something right now? We're seeing Athena move to lane right now. We might see an initiation on the Medusa.
She's just bringing back.
Yeah, I think Medusa's a little bit scared here. Yeah, that's definitely... That, you don't want a 2v1 as Medusa at level 7 against a level 7 Shivalanka and a level 6 Athena. Athena is going to try to move in, though, right now, and this might be bad for Medusa. Medusa is going to use her B here to try to get a little bit of space. Yeah, but a Wheelix and Geb are coming up from behind. Wheeler has already initiated. Geb's going to try to get the shield up. Oh, he moved right in. There's the ultimate, and we're going to see Shivalanka go down, and I would not be surprised. Yeah, Athena might be able to get away here, but there's Sejanus trying to shoot out his ultimate and enter this team fight, but looks like it is just a little too late, and he's not even going to bother taking that portal. Can't blame him there, though. If he did manage to get in there and get that extra kill on Athena, that would have really put them ahead. But right now, Medusa is going to get the attack speed buff, which will definitely pay off. We still have, like, pretty even matchup, though, in the solo lane. I'm curious to see who actually falls there first. Moving over, though, to the mid camp, we might see a little bit of a scuffle here. We're definitely seeing Onslaught right now. If Onslaught manages to get a good initiate, yeah, Ymir just blinked in. Yeah. Yeah, it looks like he's just, disengaged. Right now, it does look like he's trying to find a Wheelix. I'm not sure if he's going to be able to find it, though. Yeah, they're moving in. Simple invade on the camp. Yeah, the Kraken. That was not a good Kraken activation. No one's going to go down. They're going to move back and just kind of keep clearing waves here. Yeah, missing that Kraken is pretty big. We just saw Medusa. What did Medusa pick up just now?
She picked up Boots Tier 1.
Okay. All right. So nothing too crazy, but that's big.
Ymir and Poseidon ult down, so they can actually aggress here.
Yeah, and it looks like they're going to try to. Yeah, it looks like right now Onslaught's just going to try to disengage. I think they know. Yeah,
they can't really fight right now.
Yeah, they definitely know that if they go up against Epsilon with none of their abilities, they're going to go down. And they are going to get an XP camp on the way. But a lot of teamwork in the jungle, because I think both teams really respect each other right now. And they want to make sure that they don't fall down too quick. Right now, though, who's looking better to you? Anyone like really standing out?
Looks like Blona has a level on Jing Tian right now.
Oh, that could be really big, too. Yeah, net worth, too. We are seeing the top three. It's not a huge lead, but the top three are all from Onslaught. Yeah. And looking at the graphs right now, it does look like Epsilon has managed to kind of swing the XP difference slowly into their favor. And that could just be from better farming or... better farming right now. Oh, we're going to see Medusa. That's the second time we've seen Shivalanka go down, and it's only been 8 minutes into the game. He's going to start to fall behind right now, and we're going to see the XP difference really start to pick up for Epsilon. It's starting to look good for them. The gold, they're still a little bit behind in gold, and you know what? They're going to try to fix it right now by hitting this gold fury. We can see Ymir right now. He's going to try to aggress on them right now. Geb is pushing Athena back, though.
Kraken is up, I believe.
Yeah, Kraken is up, but we are going to see the Gold Fury reset, and we're going to see a team fight. This team fight, too, could definitely go against Onslaught right now. Epsilon has a lot. Yeah, there's the Kraken. It does a decent amount of damage and manages to take. Yeah, pretty easily takes out Shame. And we're going to see them scatter a little bit. I'm curious to see if they'll actually go back to the Gold Fury right now. I think it's a little bit dangerous if they did, though. It would probably get invaded pretty easily. There are a lot of people who can contest. That was a really risky gold fury, and I think a lot of the reason was because they wanted to bait out a team fight, but
it didn't go out in their favor.
Yeah, it really did not go too great for them. Would you ever do a play like that? It just seems a little nuts. That's a little bit too much confidence, I think. Right now, though, if you're Onslaught, you're probably starting to get a little bit nervous, right? You are seeing slowly Epsilon start to pick up more and more momentum. What do you start to do? What is the strategy right now? What's the call?
I mean, Shiblanke is falling behind. He just needs to catch up. Gold Fury.
Yeah, and that's your carry. Oh, yeah. Actually, moving over to the Gold Fury. We miss it, but we actually, Xing Chen does manage to get Bologna down.
Yeah, I think he got soloed.
Yeah, and it looks like Ymir is still pushing in on him right now. Yeah, Ymir is trying to push in, but it does look like we have a Wheelish helping out too.
He's just holding the lane.
Yeah. Yeah, he's just holding it. Nothing too crazy is probably going to go down here, but in mid right now, we may see a little bit of shenanigans go down. Looking over at Geb and Janus. They could try to aggress here. They are pushed up pretty far, but I think that would probably be a little bit of an overcommit. We are seeing right now, Epsilon is already up by one kill at 10 minutes. The builds they're starting to come together, but no one has pulled. It's any man's game right now. We are actually seeing Xing Chen has popped up in the network. He's now number two. Gold per minute, though. It looks like everyone's starting to farm pretty easily, evenly, sorry. Do you think anyone's really, really standing out? I think it's starting to look pretty balanced.
Yeah, it's pretty even right now. The gold's, it's only 300 difference.
Who was your prediction for this game? Did you think they were going to split, or did you think...
Yeah, I think they're going to split.
Yeah.
It's pretty even now, the gold.
Yeah, we are actually going to see a little bit of a scuffle go on in the top. Ymir's going to try to get a stun off of Wheelish. She's going to try to disengage a little bit, but... Oh, she's going to jump right back in with her teammates. Geb's pushing up a little bit far. I think he should back up.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's trying to bait him back a little bit. But looks like I don't... this. Yeah. Not quite sure how this is going to go. Xiblanka is going to keep moving. Xiblanka doesn't have much support, though, right now. If the fight does go down, Xiblanka is a little bit exposed. Only a level 11. Yeah. The team fight's about to go down. This could be... Yeah, Ymir's going to drop the wall. If he gets the stun off right now, this could be big. We're going to see the Xiblanka all go down, too. Oh, Ymir's going to go down before his ult even goes off. This is looking really, really bad for Onslaught. Are they going to get the second kill off on Xiblanka right now? There, we're going to see the Janus ult, and he's going to push into Athena, but Athena is going to manage to run away and hide behind her tower. They got lucky there.
This is probably Gold Fury.
Yeah, this is definitely Gold Fury. Gold Fury, they cannot contest that right now. The only person who can contest it is Poseidon, and he does not even have his Kraken up. If he goes in right now to contest it, Geb's going to try to zone him out a little bit and threaten him. Yeah, this is pretty much a free Gold Fury. That was big. They just got a kill and a Gold Fury, and now they're going to try to push. I think they're going to probably push that tier 1 mid, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, there's no reason not to push that tower. We are seeing everyone from Onslaught get back to lane, though, so the quicker they get back to the lane, the better this is going to look for them. They might be able to salvage this situation. We are going to see Xiblanka already get back to lane, so he is farming with Medusa right now. Medusa's actually pushed up far enough that she's confident that she can go back and pick up some more items.
Yeah, she's starting to get really big right now.
Yeah, that build is starting to take off. The experience is starting to take off. Onslaught's going to need to pull something off right now. Oh yeah, Vision looks like it's pretty much even.
Yeah, oh, Ymir blinked in.
Oh yeah, right there. That was actually a really good activation from Ymir, and he's all by himself. And Athena is going to move in and try to support. Janus could go down. But Athena is just a little bit underleveled right now, and I don't think she can really put in the damage that she needs to put in. We are going to see these three grouped up, though, and it looks like we might see some aggression actually come out of Epsilon right now. Yeah, we are going to see the Ymir wall actually go down here, though, and the stun, but the Geb shield is really just going to do work there. They're boxing each other a little bit over here, too. Right now, though, I'm not that surprised that in the early game, Epsilon's looking strong.
Yeah.
But something has to happen for Onslaught. They have an absolutely incredible build. I'm surprised that we've seen them perform the way that they have in the team fights.
Oh, Medusa, he's dead.
Wow.
Sure.
This Xiblanka is getting
he's
cut down
far
the size.
Behind.
Yeah. What level is he actually at right now?
12.
12. And Xiblanka versus Medusa, how do they usually match up?
Yeah, you pretty much clear the wave. You can't, you play passive pretty much. I play passive until I get Fatalis, but.
Yeah.
Medusa clears wave. You can't get caught in the ultimate. Once you get caught in the ultimate,
you're gone. Yeah, especially when there's a huge level discrepancy like that. Yeah. It's already a two level difference. Oh, we're going to see Geb. That was a really, really ambitious die, but it might pay off here. They might be able to steal a kill. We're going to see Poseidon miss another Kraken. That's the third Kraken we've seen get absolutely put off target. Janus is going to manage to poke in, threaten a little bit more.
And Shablanc is falling
the
behind.
Control room's making jokes right now about the Kraken being released. No joke, though, missing that Kraken. Absolutely no joke. It's just a shame because that's going to just put your team farther and farther behind. He needs some help from Ymir because it doesn't look like he's able to hit the target without the wall. Yeah, this Shivalanka is just in trouble. How much do you actually know about this ADC? Sadly, I don't know the Onslaught team
actually,
too well yet.
Omi used to be either solo laner or jungle. Yeah, solo laner. And he just switched to ADC. So he doesn't. This is not his main role. He just started here.
Do you think that's why he's performing the way he is? Or do you think that could be
possibly,
just...
Possibly, yeah.
Because you were really excited when you actually saw the Shivalanka. Oh, this could actually be a little bit of a fight on the Medusa. Medusa performing really well, though, here. Oh, and Ymir misses that freeze.
Janus, though.
The Janus is scary. The Janus can just get places. That was a weird placement.
I think that was just disengage.
Yeah. That was Yeah. That's really the only thing you can do with that, but it looks like Athena's actually going to try to initiate on this Ymir. Ymir gets a
two
few really good stuns off. Yeah, that was really good. Geb's shield on himself. Damage is coming in on Ymir, though. The Shivalanka
ult.
Yeah, that was a really good wall. And a really good Shivalanka ult, too. That really did stop them from moving. That combo worked out really well, but we are going to see everyone kind of get in lane right now, in the mid lane, and try to look for a team fight, maybe look for a tower. I think they're going to try to bully this tower a little bit just to get someone out of position and do a little bit of damage.
Medusa beads.
Medusa pop beads there?
Yeah, it's going to be down in a few minutes.
Oh, wow. Still tier one?
Yep.
It's a little bit of a shame, but we actually might see this tower go down for them. That's going to be really big. Oh, and they might be able to push out a kill, too. Ymir getting hit really hard here, and not a great wall. He did try to cut off two people from, but they are still coming in strong.
Oh,
that
wow.
That was a big hit by Janus. That was the ult. That was worth it. That was definitely worth it. That's going to put at 17 minutes on the clock. We're actually going to see Epsilon pull away with 6 kills against the 2 kills for Onslaught.
With 3k. Oh, another kill.
Wow, that was huge. How did Awilish manage to get that kill?
I don't know. I don't know why would he push up.
Yeah, that just doesn't make sense. That's just going to be a misplay on Onslaught's behalf. And we're starting to see on these graphs right now.
And Gofyr's back up.
Oh, wow. It's a little bit dangerous. I wouldn't go for this Gofyr right now.
It's Wardy, unless that's a soft ward. I don't know why he's not getting the ward.
Yeah, he's able to see that ward.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's no reason. And we're actually going to see, they're going to get bullied off this pretty easy. It's a little bit too dangerous.
They are pretty low, so...
Yeah, they're definitely not that healthy. They're going to pick up the attack speed buff here. They got to get them off the Gold Fury, though,
right now. And Janus is right behind.
We're going to see the whole team enter this. Geb is going to drop his ult, and we're going to see... Oh, the Shivalanka ult, too. We are actually going to see Onslaught try to get back up a little bit. They're a little bit scared of what they did. I think Athena's going to go down here. Yeah, there's Athena. There's Ymir. That's the double kill. Oh, they're falling behind right now. Yeah. They're definitely falling behind. And I'm starting to see why you rank Epsilon so high as a team. We're seeing better coordination on a comp that probably isn't as strong. We're definitely seeing the fact that Janus didn't get... Why don't you ban the Janus? We're kind of starting to see why he's banned every match. There's a Kraken that's actually going to connect. It does connect on Medusa, but I don't think Medusa's scared of going down. Awilish is actually going to take down Shivalanka, and Shivalanka is just going to fall farther and farther behind. You can't let your carry be in that position. Oh, and there goes Poseidon, too.
I think it's a miscommunication, because they're all going in one by one and just getting picked.
Yeah, they're just walking in. They're like, hey, kill me first, please, and then you can kill someone else on my team. We're not going to see them get a little greedy here.
Yeah.
Epsilon's going to have to back off and not take the Gold Fury.
That's still a huge win. They got, like, 3 kills off of that.
Yeah, I'll pull up the graphs really quick. And yeah, almost a 10k experience difference and almost a 5k gold difference. A lot of golden hand, and we're seeing that diminish right now. Have they picked up anything out of the blue, that, or are they just getting built?
Wait, what is Medusa building? She has Executioner already, and then she bought Tier 2 Executioner. Is she getting Kensai's?
What else could she be doing? That's a little bit weird.
What? Yeah.
I think right now... What would the reason actually be for doing that? I mean, it's a lot of damage.
I don't know. Kata always pulls out these interesting
builds. Yeah. They usually pay off, too, from what I understand. But it's a little bit weird.
Yeah.
What would you be building right now if you were on that Medusa? Definitely not that, right? What is, like, the standard build right now for ADCs? It's usually a pretty uniform build.
Yeah, you either go Transcendence, Soul Eater... Boots. On Shablanca, I go Fatalis because it's passive and it's one, but
yeah,
you would get Executioner and then double crit, Deathbringer, and Rage.
I'm going into third person right now for this team fight. It's a little busy. Might have to go back out of it. Wanted to give it a try, but it, even though it was busy, I could tell it was not going well for Onslaught, and we're going to see Janus get a kill right here. Poseidon's falling more and more behind. That's a beautiful Ymir wall right there, but it's just not looking good. Oh, well, we are finally going to see a kill get pulled off, and it's going to be on a Wheelish. It does look like Onslaught's managed to get a little bit of tempo right now, but Shiblanca's going to go down again.
I don't know why he's third.
Yeah, that's your carry. You can't have your carry anyone if they're falling this far behind in XP.
Yeah, he's really far behind.
At 14 against a 16 Medusa, he's been a steady 2 levels behind. Looking at his KDA right now, he's 0-5-2.
He only has 2 items done right now. He's not really putting out a lot of damage right now. So.
Yeah. Yeah, actually, looking right now, that was a nice, nice hit by Janus, and he is going to use that wall to disengage. No shame in that.
Oh, he misses it.
Yeah, actually, looking right now, want to actually pull up.
This is a free Gold Fury.
That's the second free Gold Fury that they are going to take this game. And there's been a lot of action around the Gold Fury, and I think a lot of that is Epsilon just trying to control this game, bait out a few team fights when they know they can win them. And then when they actually do take the Gold Fury, they know it's going to be absolutely for free. Looking right now, though, at player damage, look at Shiblanca. Really, really falling behind.
And Medusa putting in work with that.
Yeah, that is a lot of damage. That's absolutely frightening. Yeah, we're going to see them move into lane right now. We're going to see Medusa with Geb. They could really start to push up here. Geb is going to go back. Medusa's just going to keep clearing. We're going to see them start to do a lot of work. We're actually seeing right now Ymir is trying to move in. It looked like he was trying to move in on Janus, and Janus was able to get away pretty quickly. We're seeing a lot of bodies, though, in this mid lane. I would not be surprised, though.
They're all rotating on Medusa.
Yeah, the rotation does make sense, though. Ymir's coming in behind, going to try to get a gank here. I think Medusa read it. Yeah. All right, the Shiblanca ult. Use your B, Medusa, if you want to get anywhere. Ymir misses that stun. He does get that one out.
Nice beads.
Did Medusa just pop beads there, too? So they did force the beads out, but we are seeing Epsilon read this rotation really well, and they managed to get the kill. That is a punish damage if I've ever seen one. Yeah, and then Janus is going to drop the ultimate. Ymir tries to get away with his wall, and we are going to see Xing Chen pick up the second kill of that team fight. A team fight that should have been an easy pick for Onslaught. They should have taken down that Medusa. This is scary. They're going to lose a tier 1 tower here, too. Maybe even a tier 2 if they keep bullying him like this.
Yeah, that rotation was... There wasn't really no follow-up, so it was kind of a waste of rotation. It actually turned on them.
Yeah, it turned on them very quickly. And right now, it looks like the body count may even increase. 15-3 with only 23 minutes gone. Not looking good. Do you think there's any way Onslaught can manage to turn this around? I mean, they do have a strong comp that does look really good in the late game. Is there any way by means of farming or anything? We might see another 2. Yeah.
Ooh.
There it is, the double kill by Kata. This Medusa is fed.
Yeah.
19? That's just too much. I know you don't see them coming back. Yeah. I know I don't see them coming back either, but how would they even go about dreaming of coming back right now?
To be honest, I feel like once you're this far ahead, there's no way to come back unless the other team makes a huge mistake.
Huge mistake when they're actually by the Phoenixes or something like that, getting a little bit greedy. Geb's moving towards the Fire Giant. Do you think we might see a Fire Giant here? Poseidon is moving towards it too. Xing Chen, we're seeing a bunch of people from Epsilon actually group up near it. It's a little bit risky though.
I mean, they have Shiblanca for the late game carry, but he's so far behind. They don't have that much damage besides Poseidon, maybe?
Yeah, I mean, and we've seen him miss how many Krakens now, so it's definitely not looking too great for them. We're actually seeing Medusa right now pushing up on the solo lane, tier 1 tower. We are seeing a little bit of a retaliation, though. Poseidon is going to drop his Kraken. It gets released right on the mark, too. Xing Chen moving in. The Janus is going to swing in, too. Xing Chen's going to push them back, though. Medusa might go down here. We're seeing a lot of damage. There's the Shiblanca ult. You got to stop moving, Medusa. You're going to go down. Double kill. That was good for them. That was really good. Enough to come back? Probably not. But they should be able to take down at least one objective, maybe get this tower. We are going to see Janus, though, try to defend it. And we do see... It looks like the defense is... Yeah, the Gep shield was nice. The defense might pay off. You're gonna see Shibalanka try maybe try to push into this Wheelish.
I don't even think he could fight the Obelix right now.
Yeah, that's a little bit. Yeah, he decides the same thing. We saw
tier one.
Yeah, they did take the tier one. We saw a decent defense. But yeah, it just wasn't enough. So Geb's gonna clear this wave for a little bit. It looks like they really want to kill a Wheelish right now.
She's caught on in between all of them.
Yeah, yeah. I don't know what a Wheelish is doing. They need to. Why are you pushing in on that Ymir? That's a little bit reckless.
Oh, Geb shield. It's just yeah.
That Geb shield is so good.
So good.
We've seen a lot of Geb bans. We didn't see it this time, obviously. How good do you think Geb is as a support?
Late game, his shield is like one of the best abilities in the game.
In the game, yeah. What do you think, though? Who does he support the best? Like, what ADC would you want to match up with Geb?
It's for the whole team.
Like, yeah, yeah. So you really just think Geb, pretty safe pick whenever you can get him.
Yeah, and they have Geb or Wheelix, so Geb can knock up into a Wheelix ult. So that's also another setup.
Yeah, that's also really good. Yeah, so only that ult only works if you're knocked up in the air.
Yeah,
so,
or jumping.
Yeah, but why would you be jumping? why would you be jumping? I will not even touch my right thumbstick. Oh, wow.
No, like a jump, like ability jump.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, true. I thought you were talking. Can you actually, if you're jumping on thumbstick,
no,
will it count?
No,
oh, okay. I was like, wait, the jump actually does something?
I'll disable that so quick.
Yeah. Oh, wow. We're actually going to see. We're seeing blood here. Okay. Geb is going to retaliate. There's the trade. Yeah, they might be able to zone them out right here. We're actually seeing Onslaught perform a little bit better in teamfights now. They might be, now that's moved into the later game, right as I say that, someone from Onslaught beside him he's going to go down.
Nice.
That was a really nice skill shot from a Wheelish. We are seeing them perform a little bit better, though, in the teamfights.
Medusa's getting that right tower, yep.
Yeah, Medusa's going to get that easy while everyone else is distracted over here with a fight that really just, it's not going to matter too much. I think that was just a setup for that push. Shibalanka might actually go down, though. Okay, Shibalanka does manage to get away, but not healthy. Needs to run. Ymir wall kind of made sense there. Definitely not the best one, because Ymir really can't do anything to a Wheelish here. This a Wheelish has been playing so well. Shame has been shining this game in my eyes. Just with like the reads he's been getting, he's managed to dodge so many stuns. Oh, there's another wall. Yeah, get right out of there, Wheelish. Oh, there's actually a little bit of a scuffle going down with Medusa.
I don't think she can get away.
You don't think so? Yeah, we're actually going to see the banner come down right here.
She popped Sprint.
Yeah, and we're seeing a little bit of damage coming from the minions, but Bologna's just so strong at this point.
Jen? Oh, yeah.
Yeah, Medusa. Medusa's... Oh, wow. How lucky. That was... I surely thought that Kata was going to go down there.
He almost got the tier 2 on, right?
Yeah, no. That was a really, really insane push. Okay, Ymir is actually going to back here. So, looking at the builds right now, how far ahead is Epsilon? They're looking pretty big.
Yeah.
They're looking kind of scary. Speed camp going down.
They have 3 level 20s already.
Yeah, that's pretty terrifying. We're Bologna's being by far the biggest team member for Onslaught. Bologna's good late game, too.
Yeah.
Bologna's definitely a really...
She's an all-around character.
Yeah. Moving over to this fight, though. Geb, not even afraid. Geb's just not even afraid right now.
No, he's... That's Shibalanka.
Yeah.
For what?
Yeah, Medusa is going to, like, lurk.
Oh, that was a nice
right
Aegis.
Now. Yeah, that Janus. Was a really, really nice move off of Janus there. Janus doesn't manage to connect, though. Okay. This is looking pretty good. I think we're going to see a few people from Onslaught go down. There's the first body. Are we going to see a second one here? Xingqian trying to push them off the tower. We're going to see the Geb shield, and Xingqian's just going to be able to eat tower hits. Ymir does get off a stun on 3 people, and here comes his ultimate. That's going to do a massive amount of damage, and they're getting hit by the tower too, but Janus is going to manage to finish off Poseidon, and the tower goes down. Ymir, you're not healthy. Run. Shibalanka does get a kill, and then Medusa right after answers and just kills Ymir. Your buddy's dead. And now they're pushing right into the Phoenix, and everyone has to run back. They're not healthy. Goodbye, Onslaught. You're going to lose the first Phoenix of the game.
Yeah, this should be Phoenix, right? Tower, and maybe Fire Giant.
Yeah, if they pushed into Fire Giant here, that would be a bold move, but there's no reason not to finish off this Tier 2 tower, and there it is. Shibalanka is going to try to contest a little bit. Xingqian is going to go back. That's making me think they're probably not going to go for the Fire Giant.
Yeah,
oh, wait, they're canceling the recall, though. I guess they're just going to counter jungle. Yeah, they're just going to counter jungle a little bit here. We are going to see Xiblanka, though, move to this wave. Bellona's moving in, too. I think they're just making sure if they go for Fire Giant, there's no way you're going to contest these buff camps. I think they're just trying to make sure if they go for Fire Giant that they're at least there to knock on the door and zone them out. But it doesn't look like they're going to be able to go for it now. Oh, but this could be dangerous right now.
It's just counter warding. Oh.
Yep. Oh, they're going to open up right now, but the Fire Giant's going to start slamming in. Yeah, they got to get out of there.
Yeah.
If you get hit by the Fire Giant there, you are not in good shape. But everyone from Epsilon is returning to lane right now. Janice did just go back. They all just picked up so much junk. Medusa goes back. 1,900 golden hand. Can Medusa build anything else right now?
Yes. If I'm right, it says Kinsize, Executioner, and Ossi. Yeah. She has no crit yet.
No crit. So might be going back right now. We actually did just see Medusa go back. Okay, she spent her 2k gold. Did she get any crit?
No, she got Titan's Bane.
Does that make any sense?
It's like, there's no crit, but you do like a good amount of like 300 damage every hit.
Every hit, yeah. That will add up, and especially in the team fights. But crit, something we do usually see.
Yeah, it's like most of your damage.
Yeah. Okay, wow. They are really hitting Athena hard there. Okay, that was another miscrack. That was pretty bad. That's pretty bad. You got to be kicking yourself if you're Poseidon right now. Oh, wow. And if he hit that Kraken, we might not see the three deaths that we're about to see right here. Ymir is going to try to pop off the ultimate, but there they are. Freakster Dave, the last one to go down there. And now we're going to see Ymir go down. He does manage to get the wall off, but a Wheelish pushes right through it. The Wheelish laughed at that wall. Now we're seeing all of Epsilon just charge right through. I'm surprised they're not going for Fire Giant.
They're looking to end.
Yeah, are they going right for Titan? It's within reason, too. I mean,
yeah,
not much minion support, but...
They're all up in 30, yeah, they can definitely end.
Yeah, they should be able to end this here. This might be the end of the game. Yeah, that Titan is going down really quick. 1%, that's it. All right, what do you think went wrong? What do you think went wrong for Onslaught? The team that we said had a really strong build, a really strong comp.
I think it was just Xiblanka falling behind.
Xiblanka fell really far behind.
A lot of missed Krakens.
Yeah. A solid... I think I counted 4 or 5 missed Krakens.
Yeah.
So, all right. So they have one more game left. What do they change? What do they have to change to actually come back and not just let it snowball out of control?
I think they just need more damage. Like, not two Guardians, I guess.
Yeah. Like, actually start pushing in damage. It looked like a lot of the things that went wrong, like you said, actually went down in the solo lane. Because... Bellona and Xing Chen, that was a pretty even matchup, I would say. Even though Bellona actually, I think Bellona kind of started to win at certain points.
No, I think Bellona actually got soloed by Suicron.
Really?
Yeah.
So, actually looking at the scoreboard right now, it does actually look like you're right. So, coming in next match, who do you think we're going to see banned? Do you think we're going to see the Janice again?
Yeah, Janice for sure.
Yeah, Janice will probably get banned. You know, we're going to see a Sun Wukong ban. That might open up some dangerous things, though. We might be able to see some interesting things go down in mid. Because if Janice gets banned, you might be able to actually put like someone like Hell or something, or Nox in mid. Yeah. So, we just saw that first game. Onslaught's got to do something.
Just need more damage.
Yeah, they need to get more damage. We'll see if we get it. If they get that damage after this commercial break. We'll see you then. All right.